The EG4 12,000 XP is a slim, powerful off-grid inverter. But with EG4 releasing so many inverters to the market recently, is this the one for you? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. This 12,000 XP right here is the big brother to EG4's 6,000 XP and was actually released right at the end of 2024. Which means it's one of the many inverters that EG4 has recently released, but the price point that this one is at, if you only need an off-grid inverter, this thing might be a great option. But as always, if you guys get sick of hearing me talk at any point, there is links to this thing down below, as well as any coupon codes that we can squeeze out of EG4. We also have links to this month's giveaway, and while you're down there, if you haven't already subscribed, make sure you do so. But before we get into our opinions and experience using the 12,000 XP, we're gonna hit you guys with a super quick spec teardown in case you're not already familiar with 12,000 XP. So first up, this thing fails the tiny baby lift test. It only weighs 105 pounds, but he's too vertically challenged to pick it up. Thankfully, health and safety is a little bit less challenged and he's able to manage this thing and move it around. It's a 48 volt split phase inverter, which means it can output 120 or 240 volts. It's strictly an off-grid inverter, which means it does accept AC power. You can put grid power into this to charge your batteries, but it doesn't support selling that power from your solar panels back to the grid. This inverter, the name on it is probably one of the most logical ones EG4 has. It has a 12,000 watt solar input. It has a 12,000 watt AC input with 100 amp AC bypass, and it also has a 12,000 watt output. You can parallel up to 16 of these units together for a total of 192 kilowatts of output power. And looking at the rest of the build, it's got a decent screen. It's not my favorite screen the EG4 has ever produced. It works. You got your fans all down the left side, as well as your PV isolator and your power switch. On the right side, you have your air intakes, as well as your Wi-Fi dongle connection. And then on the front, super simple, you have your load breaker, your smart load breaker, which is pretty cool, and your battery disconnects. And taking a look behind the panel in true EG4 fashion, everything back here is super simple to understand and logically laid out. You have your battery breaker, as well as your battery positive and negative connections. You have all your dry disconnects and your communications. This unit does have a generator connection as well, which is pretty cool. So if you're in an off-grid situation and you don't have any sun, you want to charge your batteries up, you can run a generator directly into this unit. And all the terminals for all your other connections, smart load, regular load, grid input, they're all nice, solid Allen key fasteners. They're easy to use. You're not going to strip anything. Everything in here works and makes sense, except the RSD wiring, which we will get to. This unit, unlike some of EG4's other new releases, is not NEMA 4X weather rated. This guy only has an IP20 weather rating, meaning it's meant to be kept indoors. And right now, you can get this unit for $2,449 with our discount code, which makes this the cheapest inverter that EG4 has released yet this year. So jumping into what we like about the 12,000 XP, the first thing is just it performed really well in our testing. The idle consumption was a little high. It was pulling 2.1 amps from the battery, which is about 107 watts, which is actually more than we typically see with EG4 off-grid inverters. But everything else in the testing performed really, really well. It could run 12,000 watts all day as long as you balance your loads correctly. That was something that we struggled with a lot. But once we got our loads balanced, it runs no problem. It can start our big 240 volt compressor, no problem. The lights, you can see the lights dim just a tiny bit when it kicks on, but that's typical with a regular grid power in your house. And this thing, like a lot of other EG4 stuff, is actually really powerful. Like this will start that compressor, which surges at 200 amps or 10,000 watts. It'll start that compressor while it's running a 10,800 watt load already, which is crazy. Like once the compressor kicks on, it can't even keep it running. It dies after 30 seconds because it's over the 12,000 watt output. The fact that you can start it though means if you have a pretty big air conditioner, you're probably not gonna have much of a problem getting that thing going. Another thing that we really like is the smart load capability on the 12,000 XP. It was a little bit frustrating to set up. We had to call support a couple times just because I don't think we fully understand what we were trying to get it to do, because it has two functions. So the first one is a smart load. It'll shed a load. You can set it so that if the battery gets to a certain percentage and you have your smart load hooked up to your car charger, it'll say, hey, the battery is getting low. We can't afford to charge your car right now. It'll kill that and your car will stop charging until the battery gets charged back up to a certain percentage that you set it at, which is cool. It also does AC coupling. So it can do the reverse effect where it'll turn something on at a certain percentage. So you could have another inverter hooked up to do like critical loads. And when this battery starts getting too low, it powers up your other inverter to make sure those loads stay powered because this one might be dying. So really cool feature that it works both ways. And in our experience, it worked no problem. The only thing we didn't like about it was it needs a trigger. So in our experience, if you just plug something in, it won't turn on that smart load unless you hit the battery percentage that it needs to be at. So if you plug this in and it says, turn the smart load off at 30% and the battery's at 50%, but the turn on is 70%, it won't turn it on unless you change the setting to 50 or juice the battery back up to 70. That was half the problem we had trying to get it running in the first place, but otherwise it's actually a really cool feature. And overall, we just like the build of the 12,000 XP. It's got two air filters on the side, which means you could run it in your garage or a shop or somewhere that's a little bit of a dirtier environment and you don't have to worry about jamming sawdust and crap into here. You can just take these filters out, clean them, replace them. And the handle placement on this is actually nice. EG4 loves those little foldy handles that pinch your fingers and you can't lift anything with them anyways. So these are actually good solid handles that work to move the unit around. And the knockouts for this, they're super easy to punch out. You can run conduit right into there. Like the install process was overall very simple, seamless. Everything was pre-programmed to work with EG4 batteries. So as soon as you hook it up, it's just running, no headaches, very simple for DIYers. And the last thing that we always love about EG4 is customer support. You call Signature Solar, you get a local Texan. They actually are knowledgeable on the product. They will help you. They will steer you in the right direction and they won't waste your time, which is more than most other companies selling products can say. There is a few things that we don't love about this inverter though. And the first one is there is rapid shutdown functionality. Technically it's not required because it's not an on-grid inverter. So there's no button on the unit, but if you have an existing button like we do right here on the wall, it probably won't work with this inverter. And I don't love that. So the reason is most of the time, these buttons, there's a little jumper wire that comes in the inverter that connects the RSD functionality. When you press the button, it breaks the connection. This inverter works the opposite way. So you actually make a connection to kill the inverter. You have to get a different button. What I'm trying to say is if you already had the button, you already had an existing system, it's not gonna work with that button 9 times out of 10. You're gonna need a different system, which we just don't love. All the other EG4 inverters work with that button. I wish this one did too. It's also a little bit louder than some of the other inverters. Now, when it's running small loads, sure, it's fine, but you wouldn't want this in your living space. It is just absolutely humming along when it's running at full capacity. And the last thing with this guy is just the screen. It's not bad. It's a legible screen, which it gives more than a lot of companies can say, but it's just not our favorite. We've seen some of the screens that EG4 has on their PowerPro batteries, 18K FlexBoss units. This is not that. It feels a little bit different. Like I've never felt an EG4 screen like this. It feels like it's just some off-brand screen in there. It works, it does the job. It's just not like a 10 out of 10. So at the end of the day, if you're looking for a nice, robust off-grid system, this is that. It's very powerful, it's very reliable, and it's super simple to set up. If you don't ever plan on selling power back to the grid, 10 out of 10, I would recommend this one to a friend. So make sure you guys check out the links in the description below for this month's giveaway, as well as any coupon codes like we already mentioned. Otherwise, that is all we got for you guys today. I will catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.